All right, I see a green box from across the room, which means we have gotten started and not immediately dropped a million frames. So thank you for joining us again for another Super Robot Sundays here on Sound Goblin Gaming. I'm, as always, Bograt.
I'm Krampus.
I'm Shiv.
And I'm Vincent.
And we're getting back to our playthrough of Super Robot Wars V, where some of the story has fallen into a time hole, and personally, I blame the Gamelons.
Can't blame all your problems on the Gamelons. You can't.
Well, I mean, they do own Twitch, so it's fair.
Fucking ARAM players. Yes, Twitch, with the currently ongoing TwitchCon here in our town of San Diego, with signs around the place saying no streaming.
So what you're saying is they're going to stream to YouTube.
I think they are just real cautious after Dr. Disrespect streamed a bathroom.
That's okay. From what I've heard so far, someone jumped into a foam pit that they had at TwitchCon for like a thing and broke their back.
Oh, Jesus.
Is currently at a hospital having a like meter-long bar put in their back to straighten out their spine. Good job, TwitchCon.
But are they live streaming the surgery?
No, they did live stream the person jumping into a foam pit and landing on the
breaking their back.
Yeah, they had like one of those foam pits you would have at like a like gymnastics thing,
right?
Like, jump like a little square, so like foam pieces. Squares,
yeah,
except it's not like a 5 or 6 or 7 foot deep pit.
Like two.
It's like maybe a layer of foam, and they're doing like a stupid thing, like you like stand on like the. Like foam bat things and knock people off. Like
American Gladiators. Yeah.
Yep.
Good job.
So next week on Sound Gaming.
Nothing like that. We will die trying to do anything of that nature, and you know it.
I don't know. Sounds about the health and safety standards I expect from Amazon. You know, I knew her when she was like 8'6". Look, they're gonna fuck with time we get to too.
This is incredibly compressed. This is like everything from Zeta to Unicorn pretty much happening at the same time somehow.
Yes, which just becomes very awkward when you have a character that's literally in both of them, but like 10 years older in one.
And the weird time displacement that is Hathaway.
It's best not to think about it.
I mean, okay, it works out. So, from what I can tell, based on the stuff we've seen, this Hathaway is actually from a little bit before the actual, like, Hathaway's flash.
Yeah, it seems to be, like, a little bit, or a little bit after Char's camera attacks.
Basically, yeah. Where he got, like, hooked into, like, a test pilot program by Chen Agi, who is somehow still alive, and, like, is testing the G-Gundam.
Yeah, it's an alternate world where he didn't murder Chen.
But may also still... is still Mafti, but... is still, like, a couple years younger than we actually see him in Hathaway's flash.
It's complicated.
Very bizarre.
Don't think about it too hard. They certainly didn't.
I mean, they actually do usually do a pretty good job of kind of trying to mesh stuff together and do stuff that makes sense.
Relatively, it's just that this one's also like, these are characters that are from alternate dimensions,
yes,
that are from the same timeline, but different timeline. So
yeah,
it makes it even more convoluted.
Yes. Some of it does alter in the sense that like, somehow Amuro Ray was like 100 years before.
Also, see Destiny characters keep appearing on the screen. My brain just shuts off.
Fair enough.
They're all the same timeline anyways.
Shut the fuck up.
No, I refuse to believe history went that bad.
Technically speaking, I don't think Seed is actually accounted for in Dark Century, because the whole thing is that, strictly speaking, while we talk about, you know, Dark Century, Black History, whatever the hell you want to call it, being, oh, all Gundams took place on the same timeline, and time is cyclical, yada, yada, yada. Explicitly, it was actually only the things that were made before Turn A. They never necessarily implied that it was also forward-reaching, the stuff that was made after Turn A. Boy, does that become real hard to reconcile when you factor in build fighters and build divers.
It's the Gundam Afterlife, which is also in its own timeline. Well, that's just another loop iteration through where Gundam was an anime rather than an actual thing. And then they made a bunch of Gunpla based off of it and an alternate world's magical technology in order to animate plastic suits or plastic toys they can fight. And then in a later loop, they made an MMO.
Well, and see, but the other thing about Build Fighters Try is that they then actually fully justify the fact that magic is really just sufficiently advanced technology.
Because
we just literally were able to use physics to replicate the effects of the Blavsky particles.
Yep.
The Yajima particles. Yeah, the previous iteration required a magic rock from another dimension, roughly the size of a Buick. Me, I just fucked off to a space station for a couple years and thought real hard.
Hey, Crossroads. Do you actually have a choice to make here, or is it just...
No.
Okay, it's just being flavorful.
It is a Crossroads.
Oh, there's a Crossroads. Okay, we found it.
You get one of these.
We get one of these.
You don't want the submarine, which is inevitably going to be locked
stuck in the water? No, thank you very much. I saw water on this map.
Water on this map is not the whole map, or...
We're on Earth, so... Yeah. Once we're back in space, the Tuatha becomes useful again.
It has, like, the longest range attack of anything in our entire force.
It kind of has to.
Well, yeah, because it can't go anywhere.
Which makes it a reasonable unit by itself, but it's one of your carriers that kind of hurts.
Okay, so for this one, we do need to make sure to deploy the G Gundam.
Oh, we're doing that anyway. This one, yeah. Money generators.
Yep. I mean, I figured, but...
Anything else specific?
We need to... again, not going to be an issue because we're going to have most of these people on the field anyways. We need to defeat Yazan with either Camille, Amuro, Judao, Hathaway, or Benazir, and defeat Jared with Camille, Amuro. Basically, defeat Yazan and Jared with a Gundam UC protagonist.
Okay.
And then we also need to deploy the G Gundam and do not let it be shot down. And we need to have Hathaway attack lane at least once. The attack P bonus is having Camille battle Jared.
And Camille's a guest here in this one?
Yes, he will be showing up in the Regis. Stand however the fuck you want. Trash pile.
A trash pile of unit from?
They had to send Fa out in the Methus in this same mission just to make their goose seem good by comparison.
Hurricane, as we've gone over, the Methus is a great mech. You're 100% guaranteed to survive if you're in it.
Something can chip 2 hours.
It's also an amazing feat of engineering. What if I made my Gundam out of Legos? If ever get blown apart, we just stick it back together. We're good.
Fa-Yuri, Methus, taking off. Oh, the arm's falling off.
No, the legs stay. Everything else gets catapulted.
Look, we had to have a prototype Transformers.
Yes, it transforms into a torso.
In all seriousness, the cockpit engineering on that is like top fucking class. No one ever dies in the damn suit.
Prototype.
The rest of it, horrible. But
they spent so much making an indestructible prototype, they didn't even make the production models. Who we have on this ship?
I was gonna say I'm gonna think of five reasons right now why this is a bad idea for you to do, and most of the pilot super robots.
Dekuza does not care. This is a man who shot a bazooka at the Shinanju.
I'm pretty sure Ryoma doesn't care if this stuff.
This is like trying to rob a bank in Metropolis and you've never heard of Superman before. It's about to be real funny for like 5 seconds and then
Dagusa is not a smart man, but man does he have balls.
I could tell there was some bullshit occurring on my ship.
My goddamn teammates that wouldn't fucking jungle properly. Look for another answer.
Jesus Christ, try again.
It's your fault for playing with Randos.
I thought I told you to go to your room. We don't pay attention to Armando Bell.
Well, it's logic there, actually.
I thought I told you to do this, and I thought I told you I'm Amuro motherfucking Ray.
We're Armando Bell? We're like an oversight committee? The orders don't really apply to us. Also, there's a special response team going crazy around the ship because they don't give a fuck about you guys.
One of them has, like, a literal inability to perceive other humans as living creatures. He's been a soldier since he was, like, 3. He will just murder things. Like, idly. Can we not bring that up? It's not a good time for me. Anything is possible. They let my military uniform be fuchsia with lightning bolt emblems.
You know what? I can no longer agree with what Akita said. Sometimes orders need to be followed.
Ever heard of the independent nation of Orb?
We're just making shit up now.
They failed to take control of the irregular, to no one's surprise.
That seems like a bad plan. We're going to take control of Lando Bell. And all these super robots that seem to have allied with them.
We're going to take over Lando Bell and force Bright to follow orders. This has historically worked well.
There wasn't other objectives and we had other time limitations, I'd almost just say, okay, screw it, just send out the Mazinger, let it sit there, and watch them die on it. Show how bad their plan was.
According to our own convictions, kill them all.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
It stepped.
It did indeed step.
Power up the wave motion gun.
5 turns. How can I do such a thing?
The circle is not worth saving. Okay, we'll find ones that have blue oceans. Or fuchsia ones. I can only assume that Camille is a type of nonsense.
I mean, it's Camille, he's a UC protagonist.
Yeah.
Sir, they deployed a train?
Oh, that's not even half as silly as the suits that the Titans use. They have transforming flying saucers. It's,
what's it normal? That's an Ashimar?
And Zaku's with the serial numbers filed off.
Yeah, like, there's a level of goofiness from suit that transforms into, like, round travel shape that is clearly just, like, a mobility mode of some kind, to a robot that transforms into an actual bullet train and back again.
Have you the germ? Have you?
I smell a bitch!
Oh god, Camille is here. I sensed an opportunity to clown on Jared. Couldn't resist.
Oh, we don't need to do anything with the pirouettes in this mission, do we?
Not in this one, now.
Okay.
Attempt to make them not die tragically. For God's sakes.
I'm going to have to execute you in this universe.
God, Bright looks so tired in this one. On vacation, I have to get into my uniform, I have to get into the chair.
Look, based on how the timeline is switching this, you have to do like 3 simultaneous wars.
Yeah, considering Bright participates in practically every series.
Yeah.
Not in a small amount either. He does a lot.
So, weird factor that came up as kind of a throwaway line in the Kukuru's Doan's Island movie. Apparently, that's like a canonical thing in universe that Bright's eyes are weird and just dots.
Yep.
I believe it is Kai Sheedon specifically refers to him as old dot eyes.
Yes.
There's Lane. You attack Lane with Camille?
With Hathaway.
Oh, Hathaway. Okay, that makes more sense.
So we have to have the G Gundam fight the Penelope.
So attack Lane with Hathaway. Shoot down Jared with Gundam Protagonist. Shoot down Lane with Gundam Protagonist.
Jared and Yazan.
Oh, Yazan.
And we have to have Camille fight Jared. With the attack B bonus.
Okay. Easy enough.
Following this, we will get a pile of pilots and units.
I can imagine.
You go that way, I'll go home.
I mean, it's not the wrong move.
No, it's not.
We do lose this fight if Fa blows up and she's in the Mephis.
She needs to go over there.
It is frankly remarkable that moving 50 feet over the ocean didn't cause the Mephis to explode.
Can't see when the legs fell off.
I'll be fine.
You up the orchestra, it's time to kick some ass.
still extremely funny to me that in the G-Gen games, Yazan has the natural trait of Gundam Killer, where he does more damage to Gundams. But literally, all he ever did was get his shit wrecked by Gundams.
Yeah, I don't get that one.
It's just done to reflect that he hates Gundams.
Yeah.
The name of it is just sort of a misnomer. Sending units after us, they can actually take a hit.
They can't hit, but they can.
I mean, they still don't stand a chance, but they at least survive longer than one turn.
That's all it is.
Yeah, I mean, Black Getter is one thing, but like, things were soaking even from like the, like one of the Grunkins took a hit from the double Zeta and was fine.
Good every time.
Yay,
you have to kill
someone. That's our natural
20. That's just base.
Yeah.
Just also has like the lowest kill count of everyone from the entire team, including characters we haven't used.
Yes.
Which means.
She started at like
makes
nothing.
Sense.
So,
she starts at basically nothing. She's never killed anyone. She is not, unlike basically everyone else we have, an existing fighter. Someone who has fought prior to the start of their series. But the point is trying to get them.
Yeah. I really wanted to take him. They would have given her two scores to start. She got killed by the start.
Those count. Same with those ones.
That's a mistake.
You can't hit. You can at least attack the rock hollow and you can hit it in the battle. Sure.
Kōgeki mokkyō, kakurin!
I like how this year the rest of the staff, the Poohs are just fine. They're just chilling on the rock wall.
Well, yeah, because they got rescued. Neither of them died. They can't do what every brother do now. That is quite literally what the whole like Merida points system in this is getting Merida to realize, like, no, you can actually still be okay even as a Poohs. Hence why, like, a bunch of the points are having Kuru and Kuru 2 interact with her.
Yeah. You didn't even get missed!
I mean, the Mazinger's still somewhat dodgy. It was only, like, a 54% chance to hit. And 10 damage. The board only affect the board sliders only affect what we hear.
Yeah. Is this one? How's that, Hunter? Okay.
Yeah, I can affect what we hear. I can't affect what they hear.
Yeah.
Shut the fuck up, I do what I want!
Not gonna lie, you son, that's kinda cringe.
Not likely to one-shot it.
The amount of damage it does compared to everything else in our entire battlefield is, I don't expect it to one-shot, just be safe.
I don't think we're quite at the point yet where it can do 23,000 to something with boss stats.
Yeah.
Also, wow.
That burn.
That's a choice, Plutarch.
He even has specific dialogue for it, so he absolutely chose to attack Amuro.
Oh, Jesus, did that guy just... Look, I know I have sort of a reputation for being obsessed with battle, but come on, dude, that's gross.
Look, we don't talk about it. We just move on.
Can I leave? I don't think I want to fight you anymore.
Why don't you go find another girlfriend for me to kill?
All right, required fight done.
Yep.
One required fight done.
Yes. Need the other one.
That much left on the battlefield.
Nope.
No. Just the bosses, really.
There's like an Ajimar. Or,
Ankhsha.
Yeah, the Ankhsha. The shitty Ajimar.
Yep.
There's like another one there next to Sosuke.
Mill didn't even touch you. I like how the whole Gundam is, oh yes, mystery is on, you know.
Well, again, because they do have this real, the Gundam team has a really bizarre relationship with Yazan.
Yeah.
Because, like, they don't really know him as this horrifically, vilely evil member of the Titans.
Yeah, he's just
they just know him as that fucking weird hobo who was on Shangri-La. Who fucking partnered up with Gammon. Pretty sure this is a war crime.
It's death. I ejected, see, he's fine.
Look, I can see their parachutes.
No. He said he was ejecting, then he blew up. Not the same thing.
That's close enough.
Teach this troop transport about the sun. See, on a crit with Volley of Fire, they would have done like 14k at max, like 14, 15,000. Would have been fine. Could have shot it once, no problem. I mean, now he'll fucking die.
Yep. That's why we're just gonna move you to go deal with these tougher targets.
Yeah. Hathaway shot Lane once, now we can blow him up with the Amato.
That seems excessive.
Step. Look, everything we do with the Yamato is excessive.
Granted.
God, I'm glad I got out of there before the second one went off.
Let's see if Lane can hurt the... Thousand damage.
Wow, four digits. I mean, not high four digits, but four digits. Nine more hits like that, and then Mazinger would be in trouble.
Sense.
Sosuke saw that and thought it was really cool.
You think, general normal Federation pilots rethink their life decisions that led them to this point when the Black Getter shows up in their view screen for a fraction of a second and then they die?
Oh, yeah, probably.
I have chosen the wrong side.
Is that an axe?
It's technically a tomahawk!
Ha ha ha!
Ryoma only possesses one volume. Hey, Ryoma, are you going to eat the roll with your lunch? No! You can have it!
Thank you?
You're welcome! Nice job in the simulator today!
Thanks.
I guess he wants that 5% chance to say he hit Amuro Ray.
I mean, it's not that hard. All you gotta do is come up behind him with a bazooka.
It only works on paper.
But I'm tis.
Any Gundam protag works, right?
Yeah. Amuro, Camille, Judao, Hathaway, Benazir. I've gotten worse.
Indeed you have, Jared.
Yeah, you pretty much do.
It's an absolutely remarkable thing that Jared gradually becomes a worse pilot over the course of the series.
I think the intent was trying to show Camille's growth, but it just doesn't come across that way.
No.
It doesn't help they keep giving him more ridiculous suits. So.
Yes, somehow they keep giving Jared better and better suits, and he does worse and worse with them.
So we have to take him out with Camille.
It's like, honestly, like, if they had just stuck to Jared being in, like, a Mark II through the whole series, maybe he would have been all right at the end. I mean, probably not. He's still Jared. But...
Or I don't know, just put him in the Psycho Gundam. Maybe impossible. This happens all the time.
I don't know. Usually him being blown up. It's his girlfriends and other people nearby.
That part's true, yeah.
Yes, it's somebody he has expressed care about within the past 15 minutes.
Yeah.
Is that gold bar?
Gold bar?
Yeah. Gold bar.
It's just money.
30k money.
Yeah, no, that's actually a really good way to put it, Hunter. Amuro gets better than his suit can keep up with. Jared's suits get better than he can keep up with.
Pretty much.
I'm helping.
Destiny suits are unupgraded from what I remember.
I think we actually did upgrade specifically those two because we figured we would occasionally use them at least until we got a bunch more suits that we cared more about.
Yeah.
No, I think they're actually just kind of bad.
Really, performance being a bit better in the last battle, but.
I mean, they're fine against grunts, but they're not great with bosses.
Yeah.
And that's, I think, just how it's going to be with them, realistically. Now, Yazan, on the other hand. Yazan, we can criticize. That dude's a fucking freak. It's just the troop transport left.
And Lane.
Oh, yeah. That's right. Lane is still over there.
At least she's actually gotten proper dodging.
Yeah. Which is good, because God knows she can't take a hit.
every Gundam protagonist
has intuition.
It's
yep.
Great.
Peace.
In a way, it makes sense.
it's a pretty standard thing to reflect their new type ability, basically.
Yeah.
Why'd you run? Because I didn't want to get electrocuted. What? Thunder break!
He ran, so he put a bunch of vacuums on the bottom of the ship that just sucks up money on the ground because, again, this is littered with gold.
I just figured there was like an ATM-style money printer that just prints money every step that you take. The cockpit is just full of it by the time they get out.
Actually, we just harnessed the processor unit in the G-Gundam to mine cryptocurrency.
You have to move fast so the air cools your unit.
Why is this Gundam so big? It has a lot of space for graphic cards.
If we tune the engine high up high enough, we can outrun regulation. You can't legislate me. I've crossed international borders.
That's why we made the world trade.
He'll be back.
Killed some people.
We forgot you existed. Amuro ever feels a little weirded out by the unicorn emblem on Banaja's normal suit?
No.
That day, Daguza Mackle learned the meaning of hope. His heart grew 3 sizes. He died very soon thereafter.
Transits. I'm pretty sure it was Meridia Island in the actual series.
Yeah.
Also, at that time, some asshole, stole his soul and ripped it to the underworld with it. It's a whole thing. He got better, though, apparently.
Yeah, that's the, they're... So what's actually going on here is because the, like, actual sort of events of that fight are sort of obscure and weird because it's all sort of new type bullshit. What they're going off of is one interpretation of it, which is specifically that what Scirocco actually did was essentially, you know, as Camille sort of called upon all the sort of ghosts of all the people that had died to empower the strike against Scirocco, Scirocco basically forced Camille to re-go through the emotions of those losses all over again at once, which is what sent him into the catatonic state. So that's basically the interpretation they're going with here is that one. So we got a little ways. So we did get Puru and Puru 2 with their Quibblies. We got the Raw Column. And we technically got a Roselle that doesn't have a pilot. And Mondo and Ino are now available as pilots. Suborders.
Char Aznable. Cinco Colaca.
I mean, we are vaguely in the unicorn related section of things, yes. So.
Unicorn / Hathaway
/ Zeta?
The Gundam section.
Also, technically, the FMP section as well.
Yeah.
Since this is the FMP world.
Yeah.
That'll be relevant in a second here.
Do you have the bonus mission coming up?
No. Oh. This mission involves FMP stuff.
Yeah, they said that the only place they have left
they're heading to
Meridia, yeah.
Meridia Island. Or Melita, apparently.
Also, do we really need a poorly silhouetted disguise full frontal?
Could be anyone.
Surprise, it's actually Char Aznable wearing a wig.
That would be great. Best fake hunt ever.
To have Char pretending to be full frontal.
They needed a Char. I was available.
Look, I was surprised as you are to have survived the Axis shock. I was like, well, fuck it. I got nothing to do. It's a Tuesday.
In truth, I just retired to Tahiti after that.
And this game is too old to have the other Char clone.
Yeah.
We have to throw 30 for that.
Yes.
Zoltan.
The failed Char clone.
It sounds like he's a fortune teller from a carnival.
It does sound like he's a fortune teller.
I mean, I'm pretty sure that's literally the name of the one from Big.
Literally the name of that carnival machine.
Yeah. Like, I think that's literally what it is in Big, is Zoltan. Like, the Hakanan part is not, but that's a Dune reference, so... So I did see something wonderful the other day that I thought was extremely funny and ties more in with my my continuing love of Tomino. So in interview stuff for some of the upcoming projects he's got, Hideaki Anno talked about like some of who his major influences were and like, you know, what got him into doing the things he does and whatever. And he cited Yoshiyuki Tomino as one of them. Like, you know, just like, oh, you know, he's part of what made me want to do like mecha stuff and this, that, and the other. Tomino was told about this, and his response was, if I'm part of the reason that Hideaki Anno is the way he is, I can do nothing but apologize.
Also, like, that apparently Martha Vist is now the power behind the throne, trying to, like, take over Amalgam. Got a hands in a lot of pots here, trying to just get rid of Londo Bell entirely.
I mean, the getting rid of Londo Bell thing is actually accurate. I mean, that's kind of what the Foundation was up to anyways. They would be perfectly happy if Londo Bell went away. And again, like, if you're, you know, smashing together worlds like this anyways, it totally makes sense that like the Vist Foundation being what they are would be trying to like influence over Amalgam and all that kind of shit. Like,
if we have F&B stuff coming up and it's not the bonus mission, are we going to get Gowron and Gates?
I don't know why you would think that. Also, these two over here just like, listen, maybe we should form, like, a support group for secretly hiding princesses of evil empires. We can talk about shitty dads. We can workshop fake names.
Man, do they need to workshop their fake names?
Some better than others. Like, honestly, of everyone, these two are actually pretty accurate. Like, Audrey and Bernadette actually are pretty decent with their fake names.
Yeah, that's true.
They're not, like, super fucking obviously fake names. Just a notable thing, realistically, that their fake names sound more real than their real names do.
Yeah, but Neva's not the most outlandish thing, at least.
Yeah. Still way faker than Audrey.
Yes.
I dare you to try and justify to Teneth.
Because they're tight.
Yes, Bernadette Briette, significantly more real name than Teneth Dogity.
Aunt to Dogity.
Actually, now that I think about it, late Gundam, anyone who has a fake name, they tend to be significantly more realistic than their real names when it really comes down to it. Because you have a...
I'm here to fuck shit up.
But yeah, because, like, you know, connected to Crossbone, you also have... F91, Cecily Fairchild, as opposed to Bera Rona. Riddy failed to protect Audrey, as he always does. God, I would pay good fucking money to see Gowron put Riddy in like a Boston Crab. fucking walks up and he's like, I'll protect you, Aubrey. Garon just gives him the mandible claw and slams the back of his head into the floor.
I mean, I'm pretty sure Garon easily has this fight, whether it's in a robot or on
Yeah, but maybe it'd be a Garon, honestly.
I've died lots of times.
Thought you died in Hong Kong when you were in a building that exploded after being bedridden because you're in a mobile suit that exploded.
Also,
after I shot you in the head.
It's a casualty of the art in this game, but it does look like he just decaled on a scar.
Things that apparently Garon has survived in this. Being launched into the... blowing up in a AS in the middle of the ocean. Then, surviving that, but being bedridden, then being shot multiple times and blown up again. Still good.
I previewed all that in the past, being shot in the head.
Well, he had a metal plate.
He did. Yeah, they explained that one.
They do explain that one. They do explain the surviving the mobile suit or the AS explosion by saying he protected himself with the Lambda driver. That doesn't explain how he got picked up in the middle of the fucking ocean.
Seagulls.
And it certainly doesn't explain... being shot multiple times in Hong Kong and then being blown up with a bomb directly under your bed.
Lambda driver.
Didn't have a Lambda driver there.
Smuggled it in my butt hole.
Fair enough. Anal beats.
A big heat sink
blade launches out of his ass. And the driver starts up. You really compartmentalized the... technology recently. Telling you won't help anything already.
Oh, thank God, somebody turned the lights off.
Is there any woman aboard the ship who's not secretly the princess of an evil empire? My empire wasn't evil. Shut the fuck up, Ange. I killed your mother for a reason.
Let's see. The Jesco is already an ace. And the Yamato's already an ace, so we'll send it to the calm.
Yeah. We need to... Well, we need to field Amuro, but we're going to do that anyways. Yeah. We need one or the other of the Purus.
Easier if I just send both groups out.
Yeah.
We have Judao and Banaj are both coming, right? I think Judao and Banaj are both auto-sorted.
Yeah, they're not in the list, so they're auto-sorted.
Good.
They would be in this section.
Yep. Yeah, that's why we have so many selections left over, is because they're auto-sorting, like, three or four of our normals.
Yeah.
Yeah, so Skaven, Azure, and Judao all
auto-deploy.
Surprise, surprise, Full Frontal's going to show up at some point. We need to battle Full Frontal with Amuro. That's our TACP bonus. And Merida will be present at some point. We need either Puru or Puru 2 to attack Merida. We need Banajar to attack Merida, and we need Judao to attack Merida.
Okay. A lot of people need to. Doesn't matter who kills her, just as long as they all attack.
Just attack, yeah.
Okay.
To put this in perspective, we already have all of the Titan points we need, all of the Penelope points we need.
Wait. Maito is the one questioning that a secret society of evil actually exists.
Yeah.
Yeah, why not? Or why is that so strange? Do you think the woman who tried to take out all the fucking Nato in the world counts as a secret evil society?
Yes, when she formed a secret evil society with three other of his dumb villains.
Just so we're clear, they're not secret. They're like Legion of Doom style. Everyone knows they exist.
Fair enough. Fair enough, I guess.
We will have basically all the Merida points we need after this mission. We need, like, one more, potentially, depending upon the route we go on, but...
Do we need to defeat any of the Amalgam
Gates or actually,
Galon characters?
No. There is a... The SR point is the special thing, but... Gonna do Jayufan and Jayulan, then defeat Galon or Gates within three turns. Actually, we have the Merida points from earlier. So yeah, we will actually have all the Merida points we need after this mission.
Is that a cruise missile?
That's actually all of our point base. Yeah, that is all of our point based secret unlocks. No more need to track shit. Everything from here on is just do like specific things and specific missions.
That's put in the way, actually.
I'm sure you'll be absolutely devastated here that we're going to lose Riddy after this mission.
Oh, no.
Wait, we had Riddy?
Yeah.
Okay.
Now, we've had Riddy in the Delta Plus for the last couple of missions.
Oh, okay, that would explain why I didn't notice. There's no way to know we're using Delta Plus. Or probably ready for that matter, but
no. again, it's extremely one of those situations like, surprise, he will show back up in the Banshee and we will get him later on. We are pretty much immediately taking him out of the Banshee and putting a good pilot in it.
Can just anyone from the UC?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep. Granted, we will want somebody with new type, but I don't think we have many UC pilots that don't have new type.
No, not more a member of our pilot roster.
I don't know if Mondo and Eno explicitly have the actual, like, new type skill.
They're also just not good pilots anyway.
No, so. we wouldn't be using them regardless.
Yeah.
Like, honestly, we would, like, if it were me, I do like Pudu too.
That's fair. You can't hit him, but that's fair.
He genuinely might actually have AI programming to prioritize.
Almost certainly he has. Sosuke. Yeah. He has programming to go after Sosuke. That would make sense. Of all the things on this battlefield, if someone's going to go after a particular character, we got one going after Sosuke.
Yeah.
Cruise missile, bitch.
Let's see, we specifically want to take them out first, but that's about it.
Yes, we need to do Yan and Fawn first. And then Gowron or Gates. Fortunately, we don't need to do both Gowron and Gates, just one or the other. Which is handy, because it is actually a little bit of a chore to take out Yan and Fawn just because of the fucking barriers.
Well, it's because they all have Lambda Driver, which I'm pretty sure also does barrier, so...
Yep.
They take a beating.
Well, they specifically have Lambda Barrier, which is its own ability in this.
Is it functionally different than Barrier?
Well, there's a bunch of different barrier types is the thing. Different barriers work differently. Mm. Some barriers only reduce damage over a certain amount. Some barriers do reduce damage of certain types. They all have different energy costs when they trigger. It is actually a whole thing. Like for Eye Field, for instance, is a barrier type. It reduces 1500 damage from any ranged beam attack. Psycho Field is all weapon type damage below 2000 is just ignored. GN Field, all attributes with damage below 2500 are ignored. The Lambda Driver barrier deducts 500 damage from any attack. And it triggers at 100 focus, and the effect is increased for every 10 focus above 100.
Yeah, okay.
The AT field reduces, ignores damage below 3,000, and increases as synchro rate increases. But it's specifically not useful against Angel's close combat weapons. So yeah, like, all the different barrier types work differently. They just all show up as barrier, because it's a barrier of some sort. And all of them, no matter the circumstance, are ignored by barrier buster weapons, or if you have the ability that becomes everything barrier buster.
Yeah.
Ah, T.
T-block.
Thank you.
die, please. Thank you.
I mean, again, taking off 500 or more damage from every attack is nothing to scoff at. On some level, I think that's actually going to be the biggest challenge of dealing with Gowron or Gates, is just getting through that fucking barrier.
ゴキブリ並みだな。外さん。
Weren't there.
I was totally there.
That is a Shinanju.
There's two.
Yeah.
Yes.
No, they don't.
No one calls you that.
Look, if there's one human being on the planet that says that's not Char Azmul, it's Amuro Ray. You listen to him.
He came out there like an idiot. Kill him.
No, no, no. That's,
wait.
That's New Gundam, not New Gundam.
Yeah.
Subtle difference in pronunciation.
I was going to ask, do you mean the New Gundam or the Unicorn?
Often frequently.
What does Kincaid think at this time?
What, now?
Yeah. What does Kincaid now think?
At this moment?
Yeah.
Yeah, right now.
Well, I don't know if he's right. I want to hear his opinion.
Yeah, he'll be fine.
Yeah, we're on pace to get full frontal on our team. That is the plan. I mean, whether or not we'll actually, like, use him other than that.
I mean, I assume he's a good pilot.
Yeah, I mean, he only joins on, like, the last battle, so.
Ah, okay.
I mean, I would hope he's a decent pilot. He was legitimately a good pilot.
So I do greatly enjoy the slightly subtle nod. So when the NTD system activated and basically took control over, so Banaja was no longer in control,
yeah.
It shot at the most powerful new type presence on the field.
Yeah.
Not even fucking leaving. Stand on the boat, you useless sack of shit.
They're not useless, they're just not people. A hammer is quite useful.
Take down a unicorn in 3 turns, basically.
Yeah. assume after we do that, Merida will show back up so you can still do the Merida stuff.
And full frontal, yeah. Basically, once the unicorn calms down, the only reason they left is because they were like, the unicorn's gone nuts. Let's get the fuck out of here before we catch a stray shot.
Wait, I have current attack. Too bad.
With the barrier, may not do enough to kill him. Just because he is reducing damage by a lot.
あんた、ひどい死に方っていうのをすることになるぜ。さて、ラムダドライバー起動。避けるか？それとも防御するか？どっちも無駄だがな。ああ、沖の毒に。やはり無傷で勝てる相手ではないか。
So it's great. You okay? He jammed a knife straight through your cockpit.
Yeah, it's probably about like a third of my HP is fine.
So
doesn't matter who kicks the shit out of.
No.
In like half a turn, I would hope so.
Give me a second. I'm going to get angry and flood everybody's new type brains. Prepare for a fucking migraine. Feels like somebody's stepping directly on my fucking brain.
No, no, he doesn't have seed. You can do it. The Lambda driver is bullshit.
Its power is, and I quote, whatever the plot demands.
Yes, thank you, VDI Benedetto. I literally have a guide up, we know.
Yes, the Lambda Driver, the power of make whatever you want reality.
Also, strictly speaking, because of the Merida points we already have, technically we get Merida just from having the Puru, one of the Puru's attacker. That is enough points. Yes. We got biosensor on the double data and the specifically high mega cannon full power attack.
God, you're at half health already. Calm down, Judah. Not a Gundam.
Not now.
A person in a Gundam. Also, calm down.
Yeah, so two of those were Dress Hunter, and for the third one, no, Kira doesn't actually get the new type skill.
Yep. Seed characters are mostly probably not new types. I'm not going to think about this too hard.
Their own turn.
I mean, they have the seed base skill, which actually is probably overall better than the new type base skill, if I'm being honest. Just because new type affects the accuracy and evasion stats, whereas seed actually affects the final calculation. The only real difference is that there are not multiple levels of the seed ability, whereas new type basically gets stronger the higher level new type you have.
I'll cut your bullshit.
And your hair.
Maybe, Hunter. I honestly don't know. I'd have to go, like, track down what games they are in and dig through the skill list to see.
It's really easy. It's really just a switch on the left. One of the Purus, whichever one you feel like, needs to fight Merida. Judao needs to fight Merida. Banajar needs to fight Merida. And then we need to battle full frontal with Amuro for the attack P bonus.
And Mike Guyne is on the scene to help.
Mulaflaga is definitely in more than just double. Hell, both Mu and Rao, I think, first show up in Alpha 3. NTD この力があれば ジオンの宮敵 恐るべき力だ この感覚邪魔をするな 4枚までの攻撃だって Best as I can tell, I don't think any of the seed characters will ever receive new type, just because the way that they handle abilities.
Basically, they're trying to keep it to the next two
items or something. Less that and more the sake of, like, you wouldn't want to have somebody have both seed and new type, since they do very similar things.
Those two wouldn't have seed in the first place, though.
Well, yeah,
but yeah.
But it would be a case of, like, Kira, for instance, would have seed and new type, and they try not to do that.
Yeah.
Stop trying to kill my children.
Sorry, I'm trying to reconcile and remember cross-dimensional timeline differences. Trying to figure out if Judao adopts Merida, would it technically be Big Brother?
We get the weird time.
Because now we get into really weird time compression nonsense because of the fact that this is the universe that both the double Zeta and unicorn stuff is taking place in, as the canonical dimension it's from. Merida is still a Puru and is still Puru 12, which means she is still technically the same age as the other Purus. Which means she's just like a very advanced 10-year-old, I guess.
It's best not to think too much about it.
This isn't also the seed dimension, so I would say that would make a weird type of sense in the seed dimension, as the cloning technology kind of works in a I don't know, I give up way. And granted, they only ever make clones of one guy, so there's that too.
You see, Gundam wise, I don't know that there's actually really all that many explicit clones.
Just Peru and, I guess Medeva if you want to count Panzer Zeta. I can't think of anything else that involved cloning in UC.
Yeah, it's not really a common thing.
No.
And yeah, Benedetta, like, yes, Full Frontal is like a memory clone in that he basically had Char's memories imprinted on him. But it's not really the same thing. We're talking about, like, straight up Like, this is genetically the same person. Yeah, there's the BioBrain units, but those are also kind of weird. Those are, I guess, closer than, say, the memory imprint that Full Frontal did. But, yeah, other than that, it's pretty much Puru, and we don't talk about Advance of Zeta, Reboot, Gundam Inlay, Black Rabbit Had a Dream. We're in Zeon... established a base on Mars with a splinter cell comprised entirely of clones of Mineva Zabi. Dumb shit. The direct answer to your question, Benedetto, is it doesn't matter who the fuck will get the Raguz after getting Camille because we're never going to field it. So.
Proper answer. Room closet. Just like as it's received most other things.
We're going to put Eno in it as a joke. Like.
We don't build enough suits to have to resort to the Regus.
This is not Mars Zeon, Benedetto. This is specifically Re-Zeon, which is another Zeon splinter cell on Mars, comprised entirely of clones of Mineva Zabi. Advance of Zeta is extremely dumb. Just in general, Advance of Zeta is extremely dumb, and Advance Zeta Reboot is even dumber than most of the rest of Advance Zeta. Advance of Zeta.
Okay, Amrafada, Full Frontal.
Uh-huh.
Banajer, Judao, and Apuru, who all fought Haruda.
We're good.
We're good. That's it? Nothing else?
Yep.
Okay. There's no specific anyone needs to kill, so it's just...
Nope. Just need to attack Merida with those three. Technically speaking, as I said, we could have gotten away with just attacking her with one of the Purus.
Yeah, do it.
Because we need 6 Merida points total. We had 3 from the previous mission, and just attacking her with one of the Pooters is 3 points on its own.
Fuck her up, sister!
Necessary to have both tools.
Not again. Now we have to rebuild the Kashahatra yet again.
Kshatriya re-repaired. I can see the parachute.
And?
If it was a dude, you were totally allowed to put the boots in. I mean, on the one hand, jokes is jokes. On the other hand, I don't feel like that would be surprising to learn its Federation policy. Yeah, kick the shit out of male enemy pilots. Look, I am totally okay with them reusing animations and lines and such for these games, because it's what allows them to actually put out games as large as they are as quickly as they put them out. Sorry, that was a double scoff, both for A, full frontal claiming not to drag his emotional baggage onto the battlefield when his entire motivating factor is, I saw the end of time and there was nothing and it made me really sad. And also him commenting like, oh, Haman dragged her emotional baggage onto the battlefield. I was like, no, she really fucking didn't, actually. She explicitly was pissed off at people accusing her of doing so just because she was a woman.
All the blue.
It's fine. Haman will have her time to shine when we inevitably get around to a playthrough of... well, I'm not going to be the one on stream playing Overworld, but... She is a stupidly good pilot in Overworld. We actually already played through T. We're going a little out of order just because T was easier to acquire at the time than V and X. So we got T first, played through that, and now we're going back to do V. We're doing V now, then we're going to be doing SD Gundam G Generation Cross Rays, then we're going to be doing X, then we're going to be doing probably SD Gundam G Generation Overworld, then we're going to be doing SRW 30. And then after that, something. Maybe there will be another
game by then.
Another G-Gen or SRW game by then. Especially considering it's going to take us like a fucking year and a half to get through 30.
And if not, I don't know, we'll make our own next up with Blackjack and Hookers.
I think we ended up putting Char in the Hyakushiki and T. I don't remember off the top of my head, though. We did a lot of stuff in T. We played through T like over 3 years ago at this point.
Quite some times. We did T, then we started doing SD Gundam G Generation Genesis. Then COVID happened, we didn't stream it for like a year and a half.
Yeah.
So there was a large gap between...
We played through basically the entirety of the Danganronpa series between and the Nonary games between us playing T and now. Yeah, we'll see. We tend to make decisions on the fly.
Yeah.
As far as that kind of stuff, pilot swapping and whatnot. I mean, we'll probably do it only because we can't give the Hyakushiki its proper pilot. Roy Fokker.
I do understand why they don't do it, but I do miss the days when you can
freely swap pilots. Yeah.
Swap pilots.
Just put whoever the fuck you want in whatever unit you feel like.
Yeah.
Quattro is honored, you would think he's Char Aznable. He hears and understands that he's a great pilot and an honorable man.
You know, I served alongside Char for a while.
Camille throws a brick from off screen.
Oh, no, I'm getting a call from Char right now. Let me go check on that. Hi, I'm Char Aznable. Just took your sunglasses off. I don't know what you're talking about.
Hola, I am the new pilot assigned to your ship, Quinto Bloaca.
As I was coming in, I saw my good friend Quattro Magina leaving. I hope you're all treating him very well, not throwing bricks at him.
Second brick comes in. At this point, Char's got a good thing going with a one-man show.
He's actually building a house with all the bricks.
Personally, I choose to believe that the whole Quattro Magina thing didn't come up as Char trying to, like, cover up being Char Aznable and, like, you know, be able to get away with being part of, like, Ayug and all that. I think it was literally just to hide from Haman. Have you seen Char Aznable come through here? No, I am sorry, miss. I have never met before. I am Quattro Magina. If I had seen Char, I'm sure such a handsome man as him would have caught my eye, but no, hasn't passed by this way. No, Amuro doesn't throw a brick. He just sadly shakes his head and walks off.
I want you to know, Char, I am mad, but I'm also mostly disappointed.
I mean, we will get to the best interactions once we eventually get to 30, but it is beautiful when, like, Char shows up and he's like, "Hi, I'm Char Aznable. I'm here to help." And everyone's like, "No. You don't get to fucking pull that." You know,
30 is easily the best representation of post-CCHR. Where no one in the entire series is willing to take any shit whatsoever.
Yeah, it's like, "I'm just here to help. It's going to be cool, right?" And it's like, "I mean, you can help, but it's not going to be cool." That's fair.
"All right, Bright, here's this new crew you're picking up. Hi, No. Let's go. "I'm sorry? Yeah, I don't care."
Yeah, what's even better is nobody puts up with Char's shit, and Char is like, "Yeah, no, that's fair." Like, no, I get it. Like, yeah, I earned that one.
Yes, the majority of Char's interactions are him apologizing to people. "You're a real piece of shit, you know that?" Yeah, I do. Sorry.
"Look, man, I'm not even going to try to pretend like I didn't make some fucking mistakes."
I'm also amazed that the Perus could not recognize Mineva. Literally, she kept her same haircut for like 10 years.
Well, yeah, but it's the same haircut they have, so what's your fucking point?
10 years, or is it like a year and a half?
I'm not sure, but that makes it even worse, actually.
She underwent the same rapid aging technology that Merida did.
See, in this universe, once you hit like 10, 10 to 11 is just horrible for you aging-wise. You go from adolescent to adult, like, bam. I think it's a very dumb name.
Oh, we've played through 30 on like personal stuff. We haven't played through on stream yet, but most of us have played through 30 already, or at least played some of it. It's a very long game, and I don't think everybody's finished it.
Although now that I have the Steam Deck, it is easier to play. One of those games that's like verified for the deck.
Yeah.
Especially since they added a bunch of DLC that added more suits and missions.
Yep.
On top of already the giant pile of missions.
It's extremely going to be one of those games where I definitely am using a unit that is just distinctly suboptimal just because it's one of my favorite things. I'm using the units from Socket of Wars. They're not good. Yeah. Like, they're not, I mean, at least the main unit. Like, they're not good, but I'm going to use them. They're going to be part of my team. Like, then again, realistically, in 30, for the most part, you don't need to worry about optimizing your team. You have Gridman.
Yep.
There is no level upon which I can understate just how broken Gridman is. Suborders.
Next map.
Captain, our sensors have picked up extreme whining somewhere in the Pacific Ocean.
Head for Tokyo 3.
Don't do something super, 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 super shitty like torture.
Brainwash her into serving you.
Clearly that's not something he's gonna do. He's a stand-up guy.
What was his last name again?
Piece of shit, I'm invested.
Like, in fairness, there's at least three members of the Vist family we know of that aren't completely shitty.
Time is mostly fine. Benazra is mostly fine. And Benazra is legitimately fine.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
Cardius is fine. Yeah.
Cardius died very quickly in the series, so we don't really know for sure, but for the most part seemed to be pretty all right.
Yep. He even showed legitimate concern of, oh, my son isn't a giant robot now.
Yeah.
I wasn't really intending this. Shit.
Like, I did kind of train him from a young age to do this were it to become necessary, but I was really hoping it wouldn't.
It was the fallback, but my original plan was not stick a child in a giant robot for once.
Sort of the anti-Temray.
Ah, oh, Tamray. Look at my cool robot, yeah!
One of the best parts of that movie.
That's the Gundam! And I guess my son is piloting it, sure. Have you considered that maybe the whispers you're hearing are in fact future tech being given to you from the dimension of ghosts?
It has crossed my mind that's actually a pretty close parallel.
Yes.
Stupidly. So what you're saying is Benajra is a whisper.
I mean, that is basically why Konami was like, yes, Sosuke got help. We have bullshit technology. They have bullshit technology.
Okay, but this isn't really even a fight. Let's see. Char, full frontal, has fairly understandable familial issues and latched onto a woman who then, like, you know, died horribly and, like, had some requisite, you know, mental health about that. Haman, again, adequacy issues, family issues, stuff like that. Gendo created a giant vat of clones of his wife and caused the apocalypse twice.
And played Princess Party like it's 1999 after the year 1999.
And turned his wife into a giant robot.
Yeah.
And forced his son to pilot it.
Yeah. No, it's not even a fucking fight.
And yes, I'm finally every time it happened, it happened two things. Which isn't a lot, but it's weird. It's happened twice.
Weird that it's happened twice. There are reasonable reactions to things that have happened to you in life. And then there's Genda.
I don't know what you're talking about. This seems like a perfectly reasonable reaction.
His son, who he mostly abandoned that.
He wasn't useful to him until he got in the fucking robot.
It's nerve or nothing.
We are going to be haunted by the Spectre.
We are never going to get involved in any game that has Evangelion in it and not just constantly be referencing Redeath.
I was going to say, I wonder what they're doing over at Nerf. Oh, I see a little silhouette of a man.
I don't know why, but something about the placement of the portrait there just makes Toji feel really fucking short.
That face.
The 11th angel.
But I feel like they missed something by not having Iron Blooded Orphans in here and crossing both of those series, making it incredibly weird.
I mean, honestly, we will never have the single best inclusion of Evangelion in a Super Robot Wars game, because frankly, I don't feel like trying to get that working on emulation.
Oh, yeah.
But there is the one where literally, like, Shinji shows up, gets all whiny, Bright slaps the fuck out of him. He runs off. Like, you actually lose Shinji and the Ava unit for, like, three missions. And then you get a cutscene during one mission where, like, everyone, it, like, basically, like, oh, the enemy, like, shows up and is like, oh, like, we can't defeat them. They're too strong. And then Shinji comes in out of nowhere screaming in rage and just pummels the shit out of it and has gone full-scale hot blood.
Shinji's becomes like hanging out with Guy Cyborg.
Yeah, becomes literally the most hot-blooded, over-the-top member of your team.
Alpha is one of my favorites, and that's a problem because Alpha is very unstreamable at this point.
Yeah.
You could do it with specialized software, but I have not gone to the link to try and get that specialized software set.
What was it originally on?
PS2.
The emulator
The original one is on PlayStation. Others are on PlayStation 2.
The emulation is not the problem. The problem is that there is no translation.
Ah, okay.
At least not a full one.
Boss Moron!
Yep.
Sorry. I'm contractually obligated to be excited. Remember Boss Moron's.
Yes, we do get the Mazinger Zetto crew here. I want you to think about this for a minute. Mazinger Zetto fights the angels. Evangelion would be done in like 2 episodes.
And so much better.
Yeah. And yes, Alpha also has Ideon versus Third Impact. That's totally okay, right?
Was that supposed to be the Evangelion roar?
Uh-huh, yes.
I thought a whale was sad.
Yeah.
Werewolves London.
I was gonna say, it sounds like the South Park movie's dying giraffe joke.
Dun 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 dun.
Sounds like somebody bought their child a toy police car, but the batteries are running low.
It sounds like somebody in the background of another production
can't quite get
is
without its
raising and lowering a forklift.
There is a cow several rooms away in distress.
Stop raising and lowering the hydraulic ramp. You're gonna break it.
It's one of those old school sirens that you actually have to crank, but the dude doing it is real tired. Did a bunch of burpees yesterday.
Oh no, the ghost of Tokyo 3 is real.
Well, no, he's trying to turn it, but it's way too tall. They need to make this one shorter.
I dare to say, a thing did occur to me the other day as we were thinking about stuff. You do realize that at this point, if they do make another one of the like tokusatsu versions of this game, it's going to include Dawn Brothers.
Hell yes.
Since when does the Federation use unmanned suits? If they started using unmanned suits, how would they have massive civilian casualties? Or military casualties, rather. Seems against their MO. Yet wave after wave of their own men killed.
This one is completely straightforward for the most part. There's no special points. Does attack be objective, but that's later.
Beat the crap out of Evangelion 01, got it.
Uh-huh. I have to get it below 10,000 HP, and if we can do it within 5 turns, that's the SR.
I assume there's a gimmick?
No. I mean, the gimmick is you have Venus A, Boss Borat, and the Mazuko Zendo.
Yeah, that does seem to be a gimmick of sorts.
There's a second page there. Yeah, can't do that one yet, but...
These only units should be trying off that.
Yep.
Just send in another unit that doesn't suck.
The nature boy Rip Flair's in town, but he's 2 rooms over.
There we go.
Okay. That's because it is a living thing.
Stapled armor onto. Yeah, well, my unit's been renamed Super Super Ultra Awesomest Mazinger.
It's the Mazinger Infinity plus one.
No, Mazinger Infinity isn't in this one.
There's still enough until we get
this. Yeah, the TACP involves having Shinji. They come at us, we'll have no choice but to destroy them. Attack!
What are these jiggins lying around? This can't be safe for anyone.
Yeah, we are still on a timetable to actually knock down Unit 1.
Yep.
like five turns, so.
Yeah, it's not a big deal, but we do need to send some of our units that way.
I'm sure the Mazinger Z crew can handle it until they run out of energy. To...
I mean, they probably can't, honestly. It's already taken.
Yeah.
A chunk, and they only need to get it down below 10k.
That's not that bad, then.
Yeah, in total, I think you need to do, like, 12,000-ish damage to it, something like that.
Attacks twice.
Yes.
It has a barrier.
It has an AT field.
Yeah, it has an AT field.
Oh, that makes sense.
You have in that thing.
There's like a four-story apartment building inside of it.
Do proper work for us.
Yep, it is considered a third force, hence why it is green.
Yeah. We'll be right back.
The chances of Boss Bolrot and his boss robot seeing the field and anything past this mission are slim to nil. It is highly unlikely he will be the one to land the killing blow on the final boss.
We need some more focus.
Well, have somebody else kill some stuff. Like, we joke about not being super obsessed with having an optimized team. There are fucking limits. This isn't one of the games where you can do silly things with Boss Bolrot and his boss robot, i.e. Give him the unit that makes it only cost 10 credits to fully repair and has a suicide attack that does massive amounts of damage. Check him now. He might have... Nope, 118.
One short. Five people out on foot to attack unit one.
You know they don't have though. Somebody climbing along the top of the screen and dropping off on them.
Or someone spilling a tray of drinks onto their portrait. Oh, no, he's leaving.
He realized he could just walk away. Curses.
Theodore Toji Logan and Kensuke as
the person that edit is technically alive. Let's just not think about this too hard. Yes, yes, I did.
I don't know what that means. Future words.
It's just the air raid siren.
I can imagine if I'd taken into custody, Masato just ran out, threw some handcuffs on it, and drug it away.
I mean, if five people could walk up and fight.
Oh no, dragons!
Andy is right, this will clearly waste a lot of our time because it's a shit ton of cannon fodder. Take us like 2, maybe 3 turns to clean all this up. If we're lazy about it.
Still waiting around for Chindy to show up.
Yep.
We know he can kill a dragon. I assume Chenzi has to fight a certain enemy? Or...
Yeah.
Okay. So, not worried about... Kenny's to get 7 kills.
Nope.
A bigger bang punch.
Poor, poor robot.
Please note he's not being metaphorical. This particular instance of Mazinger Z, canonically, they made the Mazinger Zeta out of the fist of Zeus. It's what the Z stands for.
Ah, there's a Jigga behind the building.
Yep.
Titan 3!
Thank you.
Yes, the hand waviness of them having AI-controlled Federation units so that you can't claim hypocrisy when Koji says that he can't destroy the Evangelion because there's a person in it. Is quite literally the only reason they did that. There's ace bonus for Sasuke.
Yep. I didn't even see what it was.
Oh, no. Angel, probably, actually.
Yep, fifth angel.
Okay.
He basically just gets 10 focus and 20% max SP bonus when he sorties.
It's like we're trying to compress a timeline into a very short period of time.
Shinji's never been ready to fight.
Berserk thing only really happens if you have one.
Berserk thing doesn't really happen if you have one.
Don't give him that much credit.
I'm counting on you to not be a fuck up.
Is this what support feels like? I've never had anyone actually believe in me. Yeah, so you just need to have Shinji fight the fifth angel.
Just fight?
Yep. Doesn't have to be the one to beat it or anything. And also our victory condition now is just defeating the fifth angel, so we can technically ignore the dragons and everything if we wanted to.
Yeah, you're not gonna.
No, but...
That's a lot of XP if you think. Kills and everything else.
I don't think they do that in V, Benedetto. So the voice actors for Amuro Ray and Masato are married in real life. And so in many of the games where both Amuro and, the Evangelion cast appear, they actually have Amuro and Masato like flirt with each other and like, and sometimes even like get in like a relationship for a while. They do a lot of VA jokes in Super Robot Wars.
A double joke, because as I recall, aren't they also the voice actors for Sailor Moon and, Mamoru?
I think so, yes.
Because that's where I heard the joke coming from.
Yeah.
But it can't be both.
Yeah, they do a lot of voice actor jokes in SRW. But I don't think they do it in this one. Not sure, though. I haven't actually fully played through V, so... Honestly, I don't know that most of the Evangelion... like secondary cast are involved much past these couple missions. So I don't know if they're married anymore. I know they were for a time. I think it was during the Sailor Moon period, just because that kind of stuff happens, but I think they may have gotten divorced at some point, but...
Dumb mental image in my head. Biology sensor's going off. That's biology!
Lots of cute little things evolving around, like, Sailor Moon in general, though, because, like, the mangaka for Sailor Moon and the mangaka for Hunter x Hunter are married, and, like, every year for their anniversary, they do little gifts for each other of drawing each other's characters in their in the other styles. Also her telling people to stop giving Togashi-sensei shit for taking breaks on Hunter x Hunter, seeing as his back is fucking broken. And for him, it was an occupational hazard, not jumping into a tooth-narrowed shallow foam pit.
Occupational hazard?
It just literally, he ended up fucking up his back really badly from just having to be sat at a fucking drawing desk 10, 12 hours a day for so long.
That makes sense.
It, like, literally is to the point now where, like, it kind of comes and goes. He occasionally is able to do stuff, but for a very long period of at least, like, a year and a half to 2 years, he literally couldn't sit up without extreme pain. No one will tell me what the nookie is.
T-Shinji, these are melons.
That is a babe magnet. Cool, a giant robot. Am I gonna watch?
No, this is a giant robot.
Oh, no, got that. Shito tomenai to sekai ga.
This giant gun
that we conveniently had off camera.
That thing, which if I remember correctly, is used like once in the series.
Sounds about right.
Yep.
I mean, giant guns and stuff are things that do get deployed, so.
Yeah, but I think, like, specifically the big fucking Gatling gun is like one time.
So Shinji fighting the angel was the only thing we needed to do?
Yep, that's just our attack B bonus. We already got the SR point. There are no other specials. There's no points. There's no special triggers in this one or anything.
Now we're just clearing shit for next week.
Next mission, which we almost certainly won't get to today, but next mission also doesn't really have anything special. We already have the special trigger for the secret scenario after that. It can't be good to have it leaking out of every joint like that.
You gotta watch these.
Mazinger's pretty good.
I only know possible on that super bunker's reputation.
Yeah, I mean, the original, as you may expect, is kind of hard to go back and watch just because 70s anime. But there's a ton of sort of self-contained reboots or movies or whatnot you can check out.
Entities, I think we turn on the chairs.
Yes.
This is at least 5 turns.
Uh-huh. Yes.
That's more time than the rest of the battle has.
Most of the time, yes. I was looking up lists of like voice actor jokes and stuff and was reminded of my favorite voice actor joke, not related to Super Robot Wars, but in Shadow Hearts Covenant, one of the party members is the wolf that you get. There is an entire side quest that runs through the whole game of basically these like wolf fight tournaments that you do, and the entire thing is just a humongous Gundam reference backwards and forwards, specifically because the wolf is voiced by Shuichi Ikeda, the guy who voices Char. And so literally you face like Amuro Ray Wolf, you face Shin Matsunaga Wolf, you face the Black Tri-Stars Wolves. They, like, straight up quote Gundam lines.
I also have a minigun.
Kodai, is that damn fool dragon trying to step?
It was, sir.
Where'd Vulcan gone?
It's a fake wave motion gun button on his console so he can push it every time he's angry.
It's not firing.
It's still charging, sir.
Oh. Well, keep hitting the button.
We'll let you know as soon as it's ready.
One of two things is going to happen. Either this gun's going to fire, or my cue for League of Legends is going to hit.
It's just the angel at this point?
Yes.
Yep.
True on the train.
Same way you fight everything else. Lasers, missiles, getters.
Getting really, really angry.
Yeah. Like I said, getters.
Getters, you say?
I don't know how to handle praise. This is unfamiliar. I'm gonna run away now. Why is that man shouting? Is he mad at me?
Gotcha! All he's doing is screaming, but he's saying nice things.
Anything better to do? Son of a bitch, you got me. I'm sorry. Son of a bitch, you got me!
Think I give a fuck. and worthless.
Do you mind if I slap him? Last time around, somebody bitched and moaned that even their father never slapped them. I just want to make sure I got permission in advance.
Oh, I definitely slapped him. Oh, okay.
Somehow this still makes more sense than the end of Evangelion.
It's hard to make less sense. Glad to see Nerva knows how to incorporate every single series they can into itself, though.
To be fair, Super Robot Wars' usual modus operandi is something, 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 but then Get a Race happened.
Uh-oh, Zonder medals.
Oh, hey, where'd these DG cells come from?
Else, give it a moment. Domo, and you loser!
Time, space, art styles. I'm not even sure how he gets the scarf to stay in place.
It's afraid to go anywhere else.
Meanwhile, at the local Coldstone Creamery.
I would like a love it with every mix-in.
Sada Katsuragi, this is Rei Ayanami. That's failure.
I know, Masada's one of the few people who actually treats Sanji as a human.
Sorry, yeah. That face with happy to be aboard.
Really gonna call me out for being a child while standing next to Mito?
Mito and the Purus.
The entirety of Zambot 3's crew. The
Zambot crew.
Wasn't much.
That's okay, neither do I.
Ah, an ellipsis off.
Good talk.
Not the best ellipsis off in Super Robot Wars.
No. Suborder, so we don't forget next time, and then we will call it. And so with that, we're going to go ahead and wrap it up here for today on our playthrough of Super Robot Wars V on Super Robot Sundays here on Sound Goblin Gaming. Thank you all for joining us again. We'll be back tomorrow with more Pokemon Day Soul Link, where we see if Shiv and Hunter can manage to not kill or run out of balls trying to catch literally anything to get in their team.
Well, you know.
We'll be back on Tuesday with some more Lobotomy Corporation. Thursday, continuing our investigations in Paradise Killer. And right back here next Sunday with more Super Robot Wars V. Until then, I've been Balgrat.
I've been the Krampus.
I've been Shiv.
And I'm Vincent.
Have a good one, everyone.
Bye, everyone.
Goodbye.